good news, I cleared out the space in my phone. So, I mean, remember when I did those vlogs? Yeah, I kind of had a few months worth of vlogs I hadn't deleted on my phone. But, well, that's the good news. The bad news is I have 25 minutes to get through the rest of this. And I took my sweet time at the start of it, so it's time to rush it because we have to get back home and get to my poor puppy. Our poor puppy who is outside. We left him with a ton of food and water, but we left him. We do have to make like a 4-hour trip back. So I have like 2.5 rows of trains left to look at. Oh, cool. So let's hurry it up. Lounge of H. Archer. Also, like everyone else in my family has finished this place. So yeah, there's that too. We have said to please let's stand on the platform. Now this one's locked. Wait, is it? Yeah, it's locked. Okay. This one might not be though. No, it's locked too. Can't really see anything here. Oh well. I can look into it at least. Looks nice. Be a nice way to travel. Okay. City of Galveston, Santa Fe. Oh, lost a wheel. That's sad. Can I go in this one? Or is it just looking into it as well? Yeah, never. Oh yeah, this is a dining car. Look at that old kind of old-school dining car, especially with the glass and the design on it. I want to say this is from like the 50s or 60s. 70s at the latest. That's a cool looking dining car. And another passenger car here. Cool, restrooms as well, men on the left, women's on the right. Okay. Oh, I see some flashing lights off in the distance on the road at the end of this. Hopefully everything's alright. I can hear the sirens now too. I also hear a train. There is a rail yard like right over by those cruise ships. Oh yeah, this little switcher on the caboose can go out for train rides, but like I said, it's not on Sundays, so unfortunately, while we can walk through it, there's a little bit of give to the outdoor floor here, we can walk through it here and look around at it, but we can't actually ride in it right now. Does this one not have a top part? Just one moment. Oh, I don't know, it doesn't. It's more just being used as it's just one of those cabooses that was just kind of put on a flatbed and just used as an office instead of actually like overseeing things. So yeah, this engine and that caboose is fully operational and takes people for rides. So maybe one day I'll come back down here and come to this place on a Saturday and take a ride down those rails. Okay, seriously though, it's insane how big those cruise ships are. I mean, look at the silos over there. It's like taller than the silos that are behind the palm tree, but still, I mean, you can see the silos. It's like the very tip of it's taller than the silos. It's crazy. Anyways, I have about like 17, 18 minutes to try to finish this up. So we're on the express route here. Looking at this nice caboose here. Very nice color scheme on the outside. We have one of those breakdown trains as well, though. It's definitely seen better days. You can see all the scrap inside. And the giant hook as well for lifting up the scrap and taking steam engines that are, or just any engine or car that come off the tracks, and either putting it in there or putting it back on the tracks. It's like that one Thomas the Tank Engine story I remember reading when I was little, when James crashed and Thomas had to help him. Big hook, 1904 steam crane. Sadly, it doesn't really talk about it, but yeah. And you have a tender here. And we have some nice looking old fashioned boxcars. It's built in 1909. 36, well, it's 99 years old. 36 feet long, 40 ton capacity boxcar. One of 1500 built, besides doors of wood. And the steel ends are of a type known as Morphy ends. This size car is disliked by shippers because of its small size. 36 feet is small for a boxcar. Oh, especially when 40-foot cars were introduced, the 36-foot cars were becoming scarce in the 1930s and are pretty much gone by the 1950s. And it's a rare museum piece. Interesting. So this is short for a boxcar. Well, yeah, I mean, 40 feet, that's 4 more feet for storing and moving stuff. I can see why people would enjoy that more. Look at this one, it's yellow. That's different. A more modern metallic boxcar here. And a nice old steam engine here. Huh, interesting. It has a tender, but the tender is attached to the engine itself, so it's like a tank engine, but still a tender engine. As it's all just one solid piece. What an interesting design. That's one of those old funnels. I think those were used mainly for around places where people were chopping wood, if I recall correctly, to keep wood from really potentially flying up and into the funnel, or at least if it got in there, keeping it from clogging the funnel. I'd have to double check on that though. Louisville and Nashville. This looks like a baggage car. So says the sign down here. Oh, we have another open exhibit. Yeah, we can't get into the bay. Oh, there's a step. Yeah, it's dark in there, I can't even see. What is this? Staff entrance only. Just split into... Oh, wait. This is a second half. Those two cars here, I think. Yeah. It's totally split into two cars here, but they've merged them together right here. What the heck? That's so weird. It's like that train level in A Hat in Time, except slightly less confusing in size and dimensions. Okay. Nice old dining car here. Well, okay, the seats could be better, but the tables look nice, the lamps look nice. The ceiling looks nice. Lights and everything. Cool. Ah, the kitchen. In the hallway around it. You see the other pool there that I guess I'll turn around and go back through in a bit. Oh. I guess I'll quickly go back now. Okay, trying to get back through that car is weird because trying to rush through that part of the floor moving on me like the floor of the Carnival Funhouse. It was weird. Also, my phone is getting really hot and draining its battery very fast, so I need to hurry this up. Let's take a look at this kitchen. Take a look at this dining car that is more just kind of reserved for modern day meetings from the looks of things. Oh, I can get back out here. Okay, so at least I can get to those cars roundabout quickly. So I'm trying to figure this all out. Well, this is a restroom. This is all just a dead end, yeah. This is just a dead end with a nice little layout here. I do like this. Happy birthday. Oh. Thankfully I'm not accidentally crashing a party. Okay, past the double dining cars. Almost done, just have a few cars here to walk past. Baggage cars and the like. And a few cars on the other side. I have 10 minutes to do it all in, so I'm doing okay on time. Okay-ish. Steam engine to go into here. Hello. Oh, look, you can see the courtyard here. And also the few cars I've yet to explore. They also have like a little like car train over there that you can kind of see. Just run it on Saturdays or so for the kids. Gazebo and all. It kind of smells up here. Maybe it's just the smell of the rust and bird poop or whatever. Hello, Captain. Watch your step when up here. I can sit here, pretend I'm driving a train, and look back at all my passenger cars. Just have some fun. Look at the nice Santa Fe car. Santa Fe has a nice color scheme with its gray, yellow, black, and red. The George P. Mitchell and Cynthia Woods Mitchell. I don't know who those are. Maybe the engines were named after them, or maybe they helped restore the engines. I don't know. Still, it's cool. Oh, wait. Can I? Yeah! That's what I was looking for in the other engine. Okay, I'm happy now. I am happy now. Okay. It's an 1892 460 type locomotive. And if you're wondering what 460 means, I will simply explain. You can see here these two smaller wheels in the front. There were four of them. That's the four in the front. Then the six main driving wheels here with the rods and piston and all attached to them, that's the six right there, because there's three on each side. And then there are no wheels behind it that are part of the main engine. The tender wheels don't count toward this number, but if there were like say two wheels behind the main wheels, then it would be a 462, but since there's no wheels whatsoever, it's a 460. So yeah, they just used that to go and kind of just point out how many wheels the engine had without you having to count. So yeah, 314. And then the little push carts. Cool. Railroad display car. Okay, just have a few cars left to take care of. Oh! For starters, this car is air conditioned. Second off, this is not what I was expecting. This is more of the museum. Listen to the jingle, the rumbles, and the roar, riding through the woodlands, to the hills, and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of engines, hear the lonesome hobo squall, riding through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball. Railroad song. I should have sung that then, instead of reading it like a poem. Oh hey, a diagram of the Flying Scotsman. Cool. National Railroad Hall of Fame and Museum. Here. Oh, not here, but it's different things. Video down there of a Santa Fe train passing by. Different bits of memorabilia from throughout the ages. 1910s, 1900s. They're down from like the 1840s and 50s down there. As it walks its way up, 1910s and 20s. The 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. I wonder if those are the two Santa Fe engines that are actually in the exhibit here. Guess I'll know if I can see those names on there. Here I go, videotaping a video. Please don't get me for copyright infringement. Probably not, this is just a local video, not anything but professionally produced. Let's see. No, I don't see the name. Oh, no, yeah, I see the names on there. Yeah, these are the Santa Fe engines and the coaches that I couldn't go into, but I could look into. So yeah, they're fully operational. Cool. That's really cool to know. Guess they just take them on excursions every so often then. Okay. Nice. Then as I head into the other car, oh man, this keeps going and going and going. Size of a car compared to the size of a big old locomotive. That is a 210, maybe 4, I can't tell because the car is blocking the way. Okay, hold this up because I am almost out of time. Don't wish I had found this area first. I was debating whether to start on this end or the other end, and I guess I chose a bit poorly. Wow, look at all of this. All these beautiful plates of gorgeous, awesome looking steam engines. Just so you know, in case you want to know, I like steam engines more than I like diesel engines. They just seem to have more character to them than diesel engines generally do. Now there are some cool looking diesel engines, but steam just seems so much cooler. How much more of this is there? Different nail collections. Railroad date nails that you know when it was put down, I do believe. Yeah. It's different pictures and different points in Galveston's history here. I had the time, I would stay, but we gotta get back to San Antonio soon. At least start the journey back. Wow, look at that picture. Look at those sheer cliffs and the train track just going along near the bottom of the cliff and by either the lake or the ocean there. Oh, a philosophy. Go helping railroad track inspectors and staff at sea for sections of rail or damage or rail several times a day. I basically just use that to go and inspect the railroad tracks in the days before they use those cars that could be converted. Okay. Now we have different railroad setups here for railroad construction. So you have railroad track inside the railroad car on the railroad track. How's that? And with that, my time here is done. It was a short time, only a couple of hours, but I'm thankful my family came out here with me. And, well, it's time to just head on home. My time here was short, but my time here was sweet and well spent. And honestly, I'm really glad I found out about this railroad museum. I must thank my friend Matt from back in college for letting me know about this museum by talking about it on his YouTube channel. So yeah, but still, my time here is done. If you ever have the chance, come down to the Galveston Come down to the Galveston Railroad Museum, because it is worth it. It is most definitely worth it. Anyways, video's done. Hope you enjoyed it. Gotta blaze out.